On this week's Xamarin Essential API of the Week, we take a look at the Map API to launch users directly into a map point or to start navigation on their device. Welcome back, everyone, to another Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Today, we're going to take a look at Maps, which is enabling developers, such as yourself, to open the default Maps application. Now, you can do it to a specific point on the map, or you can start navigation, like walking, driving, transit, all sorts of different things to launch Google Maps, Apple Maps, or Bing Maps, or whatever Maps application your user has. So let's head over to Visual Studio and see how to do it. Now, of course, I always recommend going to docs.microsoft.com and tap on the Xamarin Essential API documentation. And when you go there, you're going to find every single API guide for every feature inside of Xamarin Essentials. So whether you're using Launcher, Main Thread, Open Browser, Maps, there it is. Now, to get started, of course, we're going to take a look at the Maps API. And it's really, really simple. Of course, we're going to start by using Xamarin Essentials over here. And you can even copy and paste the code. And then we can see the different types of information that we're going to need to pass into the Open Map app call to launch the map app. So for instance, here we can launch it by passing it a location, or we can do it by passing a place mark, so a location on the map. So let's head over to Visual Studio and take a look here. So here's my Essential sample application that I've been using as part of the Essential API of the Week. I have my Android, iOS, and .NET Standard project, and I've installed Xamarin Essentials into all of them. I also followed the Getting Started guide, and in my main application of my Android app, I've added a little bit of setup code for permissions and also a way to initialize Xamarin Forms. That's all I needed to do. So we're going to enable our users to enter the latitude and longitude, and optionally a name, to launch the Maps application. So here on the Maps page, I have a simple entry for the name, an entry for the latitude and the longitude. Now, I've also put some defaults here, which are the Space Needle in downtown Seattle. And then I also have a button that, when clicked, will execute a way of opening up the Maps app. Now, if I go into the code behind, I haven't done much. All I've done is done a little bit of try parsing to get strings into doubles that we'll use for the latitude and longitude. So the first thing we're going to do is go using Xamarin.essentials to bring in all of those APIs. Then down here, once we have our latitude and longitude, we can just simply type in map dot, and we see open async. Now, inside of open async, we'll notice, if I go ahead and zoom in for us here, that we can pass in a location, a place mark, or lat or a longitude right here. Now, what's nice is that I have the option to not only do those different parameters, but also these map launch options. So let's go ahead and just say lat long. And we'll see that it'll default to the latitude, longitude, and these map options. So I'll go ahead and create a new map launch option so we can take a look and see what's inside. By default, we have a name and a navigation mode. So for name, I'm going to do entry name.txt, so whatever we enter. And then navigation mode gives us the option of cycling, default, driving, none at all, transit, or walking. So let's just open it up and say none. Just don't put it in a navigation mode at all. I just want to launch to that point on the map. Now, this is an async call, so we'll go ahead and await it, and we'll go ahead and put an async flag on top of here. And there we go. With just a few lines of code, we should be able to launch our map application from the code right here. So let's go ahead and relaunch it over on our Android device where I have Google Maps installed. There we go. So we'll give it a few seconds to recompile and then get it up on the screen. Here we go. We've launched. So I can go into my map section. Here, I will go ahead and type in space needle. I can see my latitude and longitude there. And then I'll say open coordinates. Now, I have multiple applications installed. So I'm going to go ahead and select Google Maps and go ahead. And just with that one click, boom, it go ahead. Opens up Google Maps, and we can see that it even says Space Needle right there on top of it. Now, since I had put it in no navigation mode, we can say I have the option to do directions, sharing, or save to that specific point. Now, at the same time, what I'm able to do is say, you know what? I really want that to be driving as the default. So now, if I go ahead and relaunch this application, or maybe I want to have my user navigate to an office or to some structure or to somewhere in downtown Seattle, for instance, they'll go ahead and start navigating directly. So let's go ahead and see this now into Maps. I'll say open coordinates. Just open it up by default here. It'll say welcome to navigation. It's finding the best route from me automatically. And boom, I've launched directly into Maps and I'm navigating from beautiful building 25 in Redmond, Washington, all the way downtown. And as we can see, I may decide to take the 520 and pay a toll, or take the 90, even though it's 4 minutes slower, or take the 420 to save a few dollars. There you have it. In just a few lines of code, we've integrated Xamarin Essentials into our app and the Map API to, guess what? Launch a map. Hope that you enjoyed this video. Check out all the documentation to not only launch it with these latitude and longitude, but also the place mark for a direct location with an address. And check out all the other videos in the Xamarin Essentials API of the Week. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out.